Good afternoon. This is Andrew Mancini with Dot Security, and this is the Dot Report. In this month's recap, we'll be discussing some of the biggest stories in cybersecurity. First, the recently uncovered security flaws in Bluetooth architecture. Second, the surprising demands emerging from the cyber attack launched against the Idaho National Laboratory. And lastly, a look at the states who face the most spam calls per capita. Let's get in the weeds. The Eurecom Research Center develops Bluetooth attacks. Eurecom is a French graduate school and digital sciences research center. Founded in 1991, the institution has been operating for a little over 30 years and is ranked as the second best school in France for telecommunications engineering. Researchers at Eurecom have recently discovered a series of security flaws that affect wireless Bluetooth connections. The six new cyber attacks developed by Daniele Antonioli at Eurecom are known as BLUFFS, and they exploit architectural flaws in Bluetooth technology on a fundamental level. In other words, these vulnerabilities aren't specific to a certain hardware or software, but rather affect Bluetooth as a whole. The BLUFFS developed impact Bluetooth versions 4.2, which was released back in December of 2015, all the way through version 5.4, which was just released earlier this year in February. BLUFFS enable multiple attack tactics, including both device impersonation and man-in-the-middle attacks, which can compromise both past and future communications between devices. To mitigate BLUFFS, introduce a new key derivation function to add a layer of verification. Employ a shared pairing key for mutual authentication, enforce secure connections, and maintain a record of past session key diversifiers to prevent fraudulent reuse. Next up, the Idaho National Laboratory hack. In a story that sounds like it came from a comic book or a comedy special, the Idaho National Lab was breached in mid-November by a hacktivist group known as SiegedSec. In their own words, SiegedSec is a group of gay furries who choose their targets based on a combination of black hat hacking principles and hacktivism. In other terms, this means they're either after financial gains, political reform, or just a good giggle. After breaching the Idaho National Lab, SiegedSec posted stolen data on their Telegram, which was then confirmed as authentic by both the lab and East Idaho News. Their ransom demand? That the lab begin researching the creation of real-life catgirls. Since this report, however, SiegedSec has admitted that this is a joke demand and were quoted saying, "Our motivation for hacking is purely personal. We hack because we can and because it's funny to see our exploits in the news," explaining further that the Idaho National Lab was set up as a target because it's one of the largest nuclear labs in America, and we decided to target another American infrastructure and government. Our next story reviews the AppDirect report. In the recent AppDirect report, 45% of IT leaders faced a security breach in the past year. However, this number will hopefully start to dwindle in future years as organizations start to prioritize cybersecurity strategies with more emphasis. In fact, 92% of the respondents believe they've made proper cybersecurity investments already, while another 88% report that they meet all of the current compliance requirements for their industry. This demonstrates a growing dedication to cybersecurity as more industries adopt compliance regulations and data privacy standards. And now, a look at the Truecaller US spam call data. Lastly, a new report released by Truecaller, the world's leading global communications platform, dives into the data around spam and scam calling across the United States. The initial report compiles data from November 2022 through October 2023 and will be updated regularly with real-time data. The initial findings from the research, however, rank the 10 states with the most spam and scam calls per year per capita, with Mississippi topping the charts, followed by South Carolina in second and Oklahoma in third. Thanks for watching. I'm Andrew Mancini with Dot Security, and we'll see you next month on The Dot Report.